Hi all, today we can discuss about interplanar spacing. What is interplanar spacing? It is the perpendicular distance between any two adjacent parallel planes. In a crystal structure, we are considering mainly three principal planes. They are 100 family planes, 110 family planes and 111 family planes. 100 family is surface plane. That will be along the surface of a unit cell. Whereas 110 family is inclined plane. 111 family is triangular plane. Now we can find out the ratio of the interplanar spacing of 100, 110 and 111 in a simple cubic body centered cubic and face centered cubic structure. First, we can go to the simple cubic structure. In the simple cubic, we can consider the 100 family, that is the plane that is along the surface of this cubical structure. The atoms are arranged at the corners of the cube. The 100 family means that is surface plane that will be along the surface. So, if you are considering one surface here, the next surface will be here. The perpendicular distance between these two parallel planes is known as interplanar distance. The interplanar distance between two adjacent 100 family will be the edge of this cube, that is we can denote as A. This D100 is A. See this inclined plane in the simple cubic structure. One is inclined in the middle. Another parallel plane we can consider at the top of this. One more parallel plane we can consider parallel to this at the bottom side. So in a simple cubic structure, how many 110 parallel planes are adjacent to each other? That is 1, 2, 3 will be here. That means there are two perpendicular distance over the face diagonal. So what is the face diagonal here? Face diagonal is root 2a for a cube. In that root 2a face diagonal, we can see one plane on the top, second parallel plane is here, third parallel plane is at the bottom. That means there are two perpendicular distance over a face diagonal root 2a. So what will be this half distance, that is the distance between two adjacent planes? That will be face diagonal divided by 2. That is root 2a by 2 in the case of simple cubic structure.
That is by root 2. Okay, so for finding the 110 plane perpendicular distance, we considered the face diagonal. For finding the surface plane, we considered the edge.
Now see this plane. This is 111 plane in a simple cubic structure. So you can see the shape of this 111 plane. It is triangular plane. So how many triangular parallel planes we can consider in this cubical structure? That is 111 planes we can consider. One you can see already. One will be through my bottom finger. One will be through my top finger. And one more triangular plane we can consider through these two atoms. That means the parallel 111 planes passing through the atoms in the simple cubic unit cell are 1 plus 2 plus 3 inside here and 4 here. Okay, that means there are 4 parallel planes are possible over the body. So, 1 distance, 2 distance and 3 distance. 3 parts are there. Here we have to consider the body diagonal. What is the body diagonal in a cubical structure? That is root 3a. So, how many parts are there? Total 4 planes are possible here. That is 3 parts are there. So, the interplanar distance between 2 adjacent 1-1 plane is body diagonal divided by 3, that is root 3a divided by 3.
D11 is root 3a divided by 3, that is equal to a by 3. Here we have considered the body diagonal. Here we have considered the edge a. Here face diagonal of the cube is root 2a and body diagonal of the cube is root 3a.
Now see this structure. Which structure is this? Atoms are at the corners and also inside this cubical structure. That is, it is body centered cubic. First, we can consider the surface planes, that is 100 family. This is along the surface. So we can consider the 100 family. So how many 100 planes are possible in this body-centered cubical structure? One is here, second is here, the third one is along the center of this body. So that is these 1, 2, 3 planes are possible there. So what will be the perpendicular distance between two adjacent parallel planes? That will be along the yards divided by 2, that is A by 2.
In body center, the B100 is A by 2.
See this cubical structure. This is BCC since the atom is also at the center. Now, which family is this? Inclined plane, therefore it is 110. So, what will be the adjacent parallel plane possible here? One is possible here, the other is possible here. So, there are total 3 planes are possible in this unit cell. One is on the top, second middle, third here. So, there are 2 perpendicular distance are in along the phase diagonal. So, what will be the distance between adjacent parallel planes? That will be the half of the phase diagonal. What is phase diagonal? Root 2a. So, divided by 2.
In body center, D110 is phase diagonal divided by 2. So, root 2a by 2, that is equal to a by 2.
Now, see this structure. This is 111 family in a BCC structure. That is, in body centered cubical structure, the triangular planes are here. How many triangular planes are in one cell? See this. One you can see here. 2, 3, 4, 5. One, there is a possibility at this corner, and second, there is a possibility at the bottom corner where my fingers are there. So total how many 111, that is triangular planes, are possible in the FCC? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Plus 1 on the top and 1 on the bottom corner. So total 7 planes are possible there. 7 planes means how many perpendicular distance there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 perpendicular distance. This is triangular plane. So we have to consider phase diagonal or body diagonal. Body diagonal. What is body diagonal? Root 3a divided by 6.
Root 3a divided by 6. That is equal to a by 2, 3.
Now we can come to the FCC. See this crystal structure. Here the atoms are at the corners and also at the face of each side. Now see the 100 family. Here there is one surface plane. Next surface plane will be at the middle. Third surface plane will be here. What is the distance between two consecutive 100 planes in FCC? That is A divided by 2. Okay, there are 3 planes, that means 2 perpendicular distance. So A divided by 2
is A by 2.
See this structure in FCC. Which plane is this? These are inclined planes. Inclined plane corresponds to the 110 family. How many inclined planes you can see inside this cube? 1, 2, 3. We can consider one more parallel plane at the top bottom side and one parallel plane at the top side. So total how many parallel 110 planes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means 4 perpendicular distance along the phase diagonal. 110 corresponds to phase diagonals. So that means phase diagonal is root 2a divided by 4.
So root 2a divided by 1, 2, 3, 4. That is a by 2.
And the last structure we can consider here, this is the 111 triangular family of FCC. How many planes you can see here? 1, 2 you can see here. 1 you can consider here. 1 you can consider at the top corner. 4 triangular planes are possible in the FCC. Then we can consider 3 perpendicular distance along the body diagonal. 111 planes are considering along the body diagonal. So body diagonal is root 3a divided by 3 perpendicular distance. That is root 3a divided by 3.
Root 3a divided by 3. That is a by 3. We can take the ratio of these D160, D110, and D111. What is the ratio here? to a by root 3. So what is that? 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to 1 by root 2. So here what is the ratio? A by 2 is to a by root 2 is to a by 2 root 3. Multiply by 2, that is 1 is to root 2 is to 1 by root 3. In the case of FCC, it is a by 2 is to a by 2 root 2 is to a by root 3. So simplifying, 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to 2 by root 3. So in simple cubic, the ratio is 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to 1 by root 3. In BCC, the ratio is 1 is to root 2 is to 1 by root 3. And in FCC, the ratio is 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to 2 by root 3.